Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and today we'll be flying from London Heathrow to Paris. So my plan is already set anyway, so, and I did have to put it backwards since there's no like link on Heathrow to Paris, so it'll work anyway. Everything is already set, so we're ready to go, so that you guys don't have to watch this boring stuff. Except we didn't study engine yet, so we need to study engine now. So we need to press this button. And also, I did set up this wonderful custom view. Wait, I have to just do something. Let me just. Don't want that. It's actually, one second. There we go. So that's the custom view right there. Okay. Yes, so this is when we are flying up underneath this view. Okay, so engine 1 is started, so now start engine 2. So everything is checked. Okay, and also we do need the left panel lights to make everything brighter. Alright, so we do need the cabin to be right temperature, of course. After this, there we go. And after this, we can just set up the custom view. Yes, go from there. And can we go from there? Yes, we can. Okay. So now we are ready to go, guys. Let's put off the ignition and turn off the APU. Don't need that, okay. Sit back and relax, guys, and enjoy the flight. I'll try to speak over the audio, and I hope that it's not too loud. Oh wait, we do have to plug in brake on. There we go. No, and also our FPS will go like up as we speed up, as we put the flight longer. And I do have a joystick, by the way, which is useful. And also, and I do have camera shake, sort of like we shake when we take off or anything like that. So we need to take off. Turn briefly right here. And also we'll be taking off of this runway very briefly. Once we turn right there, and also we can just take off straight away. And also we will be flying at 330 kilometers, so like it will go pretty quick for flight anyway. And if against the wind, it should take about an hour and 30 minutes at least. If we are with the wind, then it should take at least 10 minutes less or 15. So like it should be an hour, 10 minutes, or even better, an hour, which I doubt that that's gonna happen, but we're not really heavily weighted, so I find to go, so like it should be able to take off from this. Now we need to slow down on this line right now. We on this line. There we go. And now let's do the checks. So APU should have done that a long time ago. It should be already checked. I've already checked that. And also we should put up lights on. Alright, let's do it. Alright, so let's go. Ready for takeoff. Soon, very soon. And I hope that it's not too loud for you guys. But, yeah, should be on standby, okay. And those sounds are from Blue Sky Simulation, so I'll put that link in below. And by the way, those sounds are not for free, unfortunately, because those sounds are very realistic, and also it does take quite a lot of work and time to put those sounds together. So yeah, and those are great sounds, by the way, and I will be doing a review on them later. Let's take off from now. Let's full throttle. Down the flaps, which we just forgot to do right now, so to be able to do it. Okay, great. So that's why you've got the warning right there. And at about 130 or 40 knots, we can actually lift off the ground and rotate. And after that, we can turn on the autopilot. And it is lagging a bit right now, but I mean, yeah. To me, it will increase as we go. It is a bit laggy right now, but it will get better. Go up. Now, the good thing about it is that we can change view like this, like a bit better. So that we can have a better view. Alright, I have to put down my microphone since I need two hands to do this process, okay? So yeah. My voice might seem a bit muffled up on sound, but yeah. Guys, I have done this part now, but unfortunately it's the speed which is right. So now we should be able to this does require a bit of patience for this. Okay, so at least so now we should be turning. Now, speed should decrease.
auto.
So now it's on auto now. So as you can see, it just increases now. Now we need to put it up to 30. There you go. That's perfect. So now we need to leave it until we get to 25,000. You know what? But as you can see right there, that's the ultimate record. We are following our plans as planned, like that actually passes the waypoint, since the waypoint might be on our descent. Yeah. And our FPS is increasing now, but don't really need the waypoint right there. Flaps are done, okay. All we have to do now is just wait. We can actually visit the plane all around, but you know, we're just gonna visit the wing view now, so be prepared for a loud boom. There we go. That was the wing view. And I wish that in the future could like features like this sound, like adding like real kind of like wind view sound, because real ones like really cool. isn't like that loud. I mean, like, we're like a bit more soft. So yeah, we're almost hitting 300 knots, close to it. I see it like emerging already. England, by the way, guys. And it's actually pretty weird that there's no weather, but that's adding some weather, okay? Bad weather. Download it right now, and now it should load it. And when it's done, like, there'll be clouds everywhere. And there we go. So that's the weather today. That's the current weather today. Yeah, it does look a bit patchy, but it now frames per second will go down a bit, but it will increase. We are already hitting 10,000 feet. The vibration now of the engine between that we are closer to the robot. And normally in a real plane, if you like click the throttle like 2 times down, like should put in auto. So this is like auto. So basically put it on auto and throttle, so that you don't have to correct your throttle every time. And it's lagging again. There you go, we're back to lagging to lag land again. And you see I'm not come out that thing. I'm in about, I think it's 160 nautical miles. We should be in Hotel. That's the Hotel waypoint. And yeah, we're after Hotel. We're after the Hotel waypoint. We should be at Test Axe. And after that, yeah, there was no more people waypoints going over there. And after that, we have to descend. We have to descend at about red 250. That's when we have to descend. So far, flight's been good. Passengers are happy. So far, so we just disable that. And we do have to wait. Talking about random stuff during flights, like what you guys are doing. And also in my future videos, I will be recording a variety of games as well. Like, not just X-Men 10. We'll have to decrease it. ocean should be about right there. The car should be straight up. Perfect soft landing, that's my goal. This by the way, I am recording this week. So like, not one of my problems in my video is that someone has to do that recording this week. Yes, last video is out to come to do this the one that I'm recording this week, but order like a camera and also in HD. And also there are some parts in flight simulator which do start randomly lag. I don't really know why, but it's just lag. So, I know it's just lag. So yeah, I might slow down the video. Let's just keep playing frequently. Once we get to like 25,000 feet or close to that, we'll be able to just keep playing. We'll be able to walk around the plane. But like right now, I need to do that because seeing this thing is more consistent. We're getting close to 20,000 feet now, so we'll have to use the engine speed. We're getting close to that, so basically engine speed will go down, so let's put it up to max that I can do is 340. Because, and on auto throttle, as you can see, 340 is what max. Put it up to 50, then we can't be able to have this with the auto speed. Right, so we're up to this. We are currently at 219 nautical miles per week. From the from Paris, actually. A bit confusing that, but yeah, I hope that would help. I'm not going to be able to wait to see because this is backwards and I don't think it's cool. So we do a big portion there. guys don't know this, but it's still moving. Now it's going down, but yeah, I don't know. And we are looking for the which is I'm not sure, but I'll find out how much that is. I would say about 5,000 meters, because 38,000 is 10,000 meters. 5,000, I'd say 5,000 meters, 6,000, something like that. I'm not sure. It's what, I just love it. by all the colors in there, you don't have to do anything. Plus, you can do the auto speed, that's just fantastic, but that's so important. The fly light, they don't have to. If I get the auto speed, I set your speed, and the speed there, I can't do it. I just well, we're close to the first one, that's basically all. Now I have to check on the phone and the flight system, like where we are. Basically, the lady says right after open, 37, like floaty. Which is more about the 10 minutes from now. No point in sending my life. I didn't even keep track of the flight. Oh my, okay, right, you do have to send that. You do have to send that. Wow, flight went quick there. Okay, you need to send it. So we can set our speed up. Here's the map.
Yeah.
bit worried now. The airport is extremely close. Can you see that? It's no fun. Alright guys, we need to descend pretty quickly now. We have to descend. If it says 40, then this means that we're pretty close to it. About 80-ish nautical miles. So we're descending at a normal rate. Now it's like this part I have to ignore, this part, because since it's backwards, like I would say that I missed the airport, but it says super speed like the other way, but who cares? We're still landing though after all this time. And I think that this video must be more than 1 hour, I think 13 minutes. Maybe just 1 hour. I hope that the sound isn't too loud, So once we land, we're going to put on the auto brake system, so it should be at least medium. Okay. So now we do need to put on our speed. You will hear it. The engines are, I think they are neat. They're on idle, so non-neutral, that's a sign. It should be idle enough. Yeah, they're idle. And once we get to 10,000 feet, then we should be able to fly 90. I guess that we will have to use the map constantly. Let me just use the local weather system just to see. There you go. You can already see that the airport's right there. So like we're very, very close to it. So we do have to descend now even quicker. And for landing, I won't be using one hand, okay? I'll be using two hands, right? So now speed brakes. Slow down now. Slow down. Speed. Alright, so whoops. Put back this. I might be. Oops, I just messed it up. But who cares? Sorry about that. We will anyway have to use that since this word is standing with it fast. So it should be 14 knots. Yep, there we go. So we are 40 knots miles moving. So the cloud bases, we have to put up the cloud bases up because normally, my weather right now is actually way higher than this. It's just like, I need a little more realistic readings. So, we basically just pass the clouds for the day. At least, like, that's good. Just to see something. It's because outside right now, it's like perfect view. See, so I'm pretty far. So the realistic weather feature isn't that really good. So we have to go down, so we have to go down all the way to 10,000 feet, right? Yeah, definitely 40 miles. It's not 20, it's 40. Alright, so we should be able to see the airport soon with our own eyes, you know? Be able to control it at some point. We need to control it at some point. So we have to put down the speed. 250, maximum 250. So let that idle. Alright, so now that this thing is off, so now we just need to turn this off. Now we'll fly manually. Now we'll fly with our own hands. This is me flying. You have to follow the line, but it's about 40 miles, so now it's at 4,000 feet. We should be able to see the airport soon, pretty soon. Let's put up the nose up, just to touch ourselves with speed decrease, and put up the speed brakes now. Sorry. Alright, let's keep on looking at the weather system. So, this is one way to like, if you want to like look how far your airport is, like, that is one way of doing it without taking it a turn to just lower them. So, normally in high resolution that I'm loading right now, it takes forever just to reload the thing. So just look at the weather map. Airport should be here now. We're perfectly centered anyway. Some of that going on. Still 40, okay. It's not that far, and I think that the airport is somewhere right now. So we'll put down the flaps. I don't know if they have to yet to put down the flaps, but. Okay, cool, yeah. Very soon, let's put it up to 2 now. For now, because since this can't really look at the airport yet, we shouldn't really put our flaps down just to lose speed. And with the feature of the auto light, we don't have to worry about speed yet. And we will switch off the auto light. Somewhere close. Check them out. show yourself. At the airport? Yeah, that's the airport. Right there. Okay, right. So we will have to do a pretty big turn right there, because since the airport, I will explain to you this. But since the airport runway is right there, we'll have to do a sharp turn. Sharp turn means to land like perfectly like this way instead of this way. This way doesn't work, so the airport's right there. Straight after we pass that river, we have to put flaps for things. Because, I need to get it ripped. Yeah, and also, the trick of X-Plane 10, in the noon time, you can actually get tricked with taxiways. So yes, you have to be careful. Now we can put down the landing gear. So put down the landing gear. That's Paris, by the way. Party? Paris is right there. Well, Paris is right there. Should be now down. 3, 2, 1, boom! You hit an landing gear in the video machine. Once we landed perfectly by the runway, right, so this is a time where I have to use this view, guys. I just use this view just to, because since the bar is in the way, it's not that useful, so if you guys don't mind. That is Paris, by the way. In front of you guys right there, that is Paris, by the way. That is the airport right there. This is actually in full resolution, you know, like it's actually in full best Paris, you know, best Paris. Normally, you are legal to fly over Paris for planes in your life. So yeah. So now that's set. Right, no more auto throttle, because we need to use both of our hands now. So you won't really hear my voice that much because I'm putting my foot away from my mouth. So yeah, see you guys right after we do the landing today, because you'll be able to hear my voice since by the way guys, for this whole video, I've been holding my phone up to my mouth to actually speak. The landing
500.
Thirty. 20.
joining this flight, and also we'll be passing through our gates very shortly. So that was a full flight from London Heathrow to Paris. That wasn't really the best landing, but I tried to make it as soft as possible. Apparently it was soft to the third passengers. So with that specific view, it doesn't really seem like that's all, because yeah, there's no view, but from this current view right now, like, we were pretty high, so we were like about 50 feet away from touching the ground. So now we have to find our gate, which is actually pre-selected for us. Like, it's actually I think it was right there. So we have to navigate to the place. Let's turn on, let's put up the flaps up again. So let's let's put the flaps and let's slow down. Down up to almost lower. So now let's turn on the ECU. We don't need the lights anymore, separate navi logo ones, and yeah, so that should be fine. And that should also attach it to our gate, and we have a couple of preparations for the next flight. And this won't be today, because it's a long flight that we did, and also I don't have time to upload it, because yeah, it can take up to like to midnight to upload too. So we do have to obey the rules right here, and I don't know what the fuck is going on. So anyway, let's just go. Just to make this a bit faster, like, we would just park somewhere. So this is, we just park like somewhere there, I'd say. Just to make it quicker for you guys. Not to bore you guys with this. So. Now that we did that, we need to just turn the plane now. Slow down, man. I think that there's space for us. Yes, there's space. Yes, there is. Sorry, I can barely speak right now. Yes, there is space for us. Well, that's what it is. Right. Okay, let's the game there, because since it just right, okay, so now right, so now we need to, now that you set already, we need to just look at our couple of things. Okay, everything looks fine. Okay, now I need to turn off my fucking seatbelt. Okay, just learning up how we need to do that, and then there's no flight plans expected, so yeah. Everything looks right, so do we put on anything so we don't. Alright, so let's switch off the engine sound. There we go. Hold those in park. Thank you. Cargo doors and everything. So yeah, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and please like and subscribe for more awesome content or longer content that you want me to do. So yeah, thank you, and as always, thanks for watching. Peace.